are planning this year's vacation, there are, of course, many countries you could choose from. Why not try Slovenia? Slovenia is a small country between the Alps and the sea. Nowhere in Europe is the sea as close to the Alps as it is here. And between the white mountains and the blue sea are all the beauties one could wish for. Mountain valleys, lonely rivers, soft vine-covered hills which produce rich and fine fruit with enticing bouquet, color and taste. This small corner of the earth won first prize in nature's lottery. Mighty mountains, dreamy meadows among soft hills where you can find everything. In untouched nature, there is solitude which some prefer above all else. Or there is the loud laughter of happy, hospitable people who enjoy life and among whom you will not lack company. Visit Slovenia. There are various ways of getting to Slovenia. Most tourists come by road, some over the mountain passes, others over the plains if they want to avoid going too high up. The roads are quite good, but of course they are not very lonely during the tourist season. You can also come by sea, by boat to Koper Harbor, or with your private yacht to the nearby Piran. You can come by air to Ljubljana's airport, Brnik. If you don't like jets, well, obstinate loners can look for other ways. Some even find them. Then they really do travel alone and avoid the columns on the road. But of course, they cannot take 7 suitcases along. However you come, you will always be welcome. And whichever direction you come from, you cannot bypass Ljubljana. It lies in the heart of the country and is its capital. It is not big, 200,000 inhabitants. You quickly find your way around. The big highways which run through the city make orientation easy and help you feel at home. Many people come to Ljubljana again and again because of the low prices in the leatherware shops, at the furriers and elsewhere. Others come because of the good cooking in Ljubljana hotels. And still others simply because they say that Ljubljana is little Paris. Yes, if Paris were a lot smaller, if it were 35 miles from the Alps and 70 miles from the sea, then Ljubljana would be Paris. It has beautiful, imposing buildings below which vibrant life pulses. Ljubljana also has a river which divides the city into two parts. The beauty of the city and the picturesque life there, that is the real charm of Ljubljana. Yes, stone, even the most finely chiseled, is nothing without the lively company of human hearts. That is Ljubljana. It has enchanted everyone who stopped over for a day or two before continuing on the way around Slovenia. If you set off towards the northeast, the signpost said Maribor. The second largest city in Slovenia lies where the last slopes of the Alps level out into the Pannonian Plain. Almost from within the city itself, cable cars bring visitors up to the Porphyrian Mountains, which, like many others in Slovenia, are a skier's paradise in winter, while in summer they welcome all those seeking peat and other forest fruits, including the sort which can be tastefully prepared. On the low hills which run out into the Pannonian Plains, they grow wine, which connoisseurs consider among the best. Well, cheerio! Purely accidentally, it is really just a coincidence, the area which produces these good things is also known for its many spas and thermal baths, where you can cure stomach, liver, gallbladder, or just simply enjoy the peace and quiet. On the Prekmurje Plains, many old customs still live on, among them one of the oldest in Europe, the wild dance of the masked kuren. The This custom is over 1,000 years old, and even older is a folk art which is still preserved, although it is slowly dying out. Art lovers can still find all sorts of beautiful things for a song. Have to book your hotel well in advance in this district. In this hunter's paradise, poplar, hair fly $3, softly, another three, and three again, $9 altogether. Well, in this hunter's paradise, be still, careful. Aha, here are another $3 wandering around. You know, hunting is not such an expensive sport after all. What we were going to say was that in this hunter's paradise, but now we really must be still. Good hunting! The eastern end of the Alps are the Julian Alps, and the Julian Alps are in Slovenia, on its northern border, less than an hour's drive from Ljubljana. Some people there by vacations like this, nothing else will do. On vacation they want to forget everything below 5,000 feet, because down there are worries, there are crowds, there is a daily trek of the city as well. But up here, there is heavenly peace. Yes, and the people's sense of humor, a little rough, but refreshing, all the same, or perhaps it is. 3/4 of an hour's drive from Ljubljana, and 1/4 of an hour from the Austrian border, among the mountains, lies the jewel of the Alps, Lake Bled. Here, if you like, you can stay in the most luxurious of hotels, or you can set up your tent by the water. Nature lovers are well served by the best possible host, nature herself. Lake Borkin, 16 miles from Bled, is bigger and wilder and imposing in its solitude. But if you feel like taking the good road over the mountain passes into the valley of the Blue Soldier, into the silence of its meadows and woods, once you have seen the Slovene Alps, you will remember them always. There are all sorts of people, and some of them do not like the sharply edged Alps, but prefer a softer landscape, homely little hotels and inns. Slovenia can offer that too, the Dolenska Hills. In the dim past, Asia passed through here and on, right up to the doors of Europe. Now, only memories of that remain, the ruins of many proud castles beneath which in the Slovene rivers, Europe fishes today. Some of these old castles, artists, among the old art, new works of art are created. In this castle country, the beauties of nature go hand in hand with those created by the human spirit and human hand. This is not only good fishing country. Not far from here, there are real virgin forests where hunters stalk quite different game, deer and bears.
course, most tourists come to Slovenia because of its blue sea. A seaside holiday has become an integral part of modern life. The hot sun and the warm water cure all ills, except love, which they say they even encourage. But that is not a serious illness, and so there are whole towns of friendly new hotels along the Slovene coast, and the sea is warmer than anywhere else in the Adriatic. Of course, a successful holiday calls for a little initiative, too. That is essential. Some people take advantage of every suitable opportunity, and others overdo things and take advantage, when they must, of unsuitable opportunities as well. All people don't appreciate the crowds on the beaches and prefer a lonely spot all to themselves. There are enough such places, too, but nowadays they are not as many as they used to be. However that may be, on the Slovene coast you have sun and warm sea as early as May and as late as September, and you hear all European languages here. There is something for everyone, and it is always just the right thing. And you can plan your vacation to suit your own taste and your hobby. Hobbies differ considerably. Just as people are different, so their favorite occupations differ. And vacation time is just the right time for doing the things we like to. So on the Slovene coast, we cater for everything and everyone, even for those whose hobby is roulette. But for those who like looking at beautiful things, not only on the beach, there are mementos of old cultures, full of simple, witty folklore. For that, you don't have to go far from the coast, only a few miles, let's say to Hrastovje, or to Lipica, the home of the white Lipicana horses, the stars of the Viennese riding school. Or to the Kras, where we find not only the world famous for Stojna caves, but all sorts of wondrous things. It is as if nature had decided that this area, on the way to the Slovene coast, must be made as beautiful as possible to prevent this part of Slovenia from feeling neglected in comparison to the others. Visit Slovenia. You won't regret it. What is it you want? Speak up, because Slovenia is a good fairy who can fulfill all wishes. Do you want the endless peace of the Slovene Alps? The warm, sunny Adriatic. Or perhaps the soft, dreamy hills where the best wine grows. You will be welcome wherever you go, because the people who live here are cheerful and hospitable. How could they be anything else in this little country of wondrous beauty?